This is Kumar, you are watching Kumar's Academy. Today I am going to discuss about 18th century literature. Before knowing 18th century, we have to see its social, political, economical and historical backgrounds. Dethrone of James II at the time of Glorious Revolution of 1688. At the time of 18th century, the Glorious Revolution took place. The first time that Glorious Revolution, the word was used by Hampden. What this Glorious Revolution it is in real sense? After the death of Charles II, his brother James II, who ascended the throne and he became the king, he had two daughters. One is Mary II. And second one is Anne. James II, his rule was biased rule. He was a Catholic. He hated the Protestant and executed many Protestant. So English people revolted against him. Mary II, who got married to William III of Dutch, or you can call him William of Orange. When William of Orange was attacked by 14 Louis of France, William III expected the help from James II, but James II quite kept. William got angry, convinced his wife. William III, who brought his army to England, when James II heard the attack on him by William of Orange, he fled away to England and spent the whole life and died there. The England throne later jointly was ascended by William III and his wife Mary II. Unfortunately, Mary II had no any children and she died so early. Later, after the death of William of Orange or William III, the throne was ascended by Mary II's sister Anne, and she ruled in England as a Queen Anne. So next point is the political background. There was a rise of political parties in 1700 when the Charles II was a monarch of England. The political parties were Whig and Tory. The domestic politicians were divided into two groups, as a Whig, as a Tory. But they hated each other, but never approached bloodshed. Whig party stood for personal freedom. Tory stood for royal divinity right. Whig supported Hanoverian king, the German king. Hanoverian, they are Germans. When Queen Anne died without children, her husband George I, their cousin and relatives who ascended the throne, and after that, the rule of George I, II, III, IV, and even William IV till Queen Victoria ruled England, these descent is called the Hanoverian descent. Tories supported Jacobites. In the matter of religion, Whig were considered as a low churchman and Tories were considered as a high churchman. Next, the characteristics of the literature or the features of the literary art of 18th century. There was predominance of prose. Prose which became very famous, and essay was written. The great writers who contributed more to the satires and essays, and they gave emphasis on wit and common sense. Wit and common sense which ruled by their writings, and the lyric lost its substance. And no lyric poetry was written. Their writing was given importance to the correctness and neatness, and it became a technique. And the heroic couplet was given more stress. And most of the writers who wrote poems in heroic couplet, the great writer like Pope and Prior and Edward King and even the essayist Joe Swift and Edison, Steele, Depot, who wrote poems as well as the essays, they used heroic couplet. The political writing, when they wrote about politics, there was a competition between two parties, Whig and Tories. Already I have mentioned it. They were criticizing each other, and the clubs and copy houses were established. They thought it's a symbol of their fashion and public life, and it was said that there were 2,000 clubs were in England at 18th century, and it was the literature of the town. They wrote about urbanity, they wrote the manners, fashion, the symbol of hypocrisy. So this was, we can see in 18th century. The writers who also associated with each other, and they also formed the clubs. Example, Scriblerus and Kit Kat Club. Scriblerus Club was founded in 1713 at the time of Augustine. They supported Tories. The prominent writers, the prominent figures are such as Swift, Alexander Pope, John Gay, John Arbuthnot, Thomas Parnell, Richard Owen, Cambridge. And another club, Kit Kat Clubs, it supported to Whigs, and they wrote it in called Trumpet Tavern, London. The prominent writers of this club are Steele, Edison, Congreve, Robert Walpole, Duke of Marlborough. This was called Kit Kat Club because there was an innkeeper called Christopher Cat. So that's why it was called. And the rise of publishing houses and magazines, the more prominent magazines such as Examiner, Guardians, Freeholders. So the writers who contributed them, and easily their piece of work was published. So that's why it became very easy to publish their works. Next, there was a decline in drama. The drama was written, but they didn't get success. When they were heyday in restoration period in 18th century, they declined. Here the Grub Street is mentioned. It is called the place of the writers who were coming to London, staying at the Grub Street. It is very grudgy street. They were searching the food of their livelihood by writing the piece of work. And one more important thing is that the writers who stressed, emphasized on morality while writing, their importance was to give morality, enlightenment, and more importance to the reason. This age is called by many names, such as Augustan age, age of Pope, neoclassical age, age of prose and reason, age of enlightenment. The Augustan age, it begins from 1700 to 1745. Leading writers of the period, Pope, Swift, Addison, Steele, they emphasized on social concerns and ideals of the moderation, decorum, urbanity. Goldsmith was the first to call the age Augustan. And this is Augustan because the writers who were imitating the Augustan Caesar's age of Rome, which starts from 1400 AD to 27 BC. There were great writers such as Cicero, Ovid, Virgil, and many more. So they are writing, imitating the writers of Rome. Next, it is called age of Pope because Pope, who represent the age, who dominated the age, his poetry such as Rape of the Lock, Dunciad, translation of Homer's Iliad, Odyssey, and these are very great piece of work, and he dominated the whole era. So third one, it is called Neoclassical age. It starts from 1700 to 1798. The age of Pope, you may call it even the age of Pope or the Dr. Johnson also. Neoclassical age is divided into two parts. I have told you that it is called even age of Johnson also. 1700 to 1740 called age of Pope. 1740 to 1798 is called the age of Dr. Johnson. During this period, Queen Anne and three George ruled England. Matthew Arnold refers this period our admirable and indispensable. In this age, there was a rise of social essays and a novel, development of the modern prose style, and a French influenced dominated, and more rigid and stringent we can find in this age. And another one, the fourth one, is the age of prose and reason. Matthew Arnold called the age of prose and reason. In this period, interest in changed political and social condition, demand of pamphlets, magazines and a newspaper. So prose writers such as Addison, Steele, Swift, Depot, Gibbon and Burke, who contributed to the many magazines and newspapers, and even they wrote pamphlets. Poetry itself became the prosaic. No creativity and no imagination was found. Ethical essays, satire and criticism was written. Polished and refined can be found in Pope's poetry. There was a lacks of fire, fashion and even enthusiasm and realism, which really dominated. Wit and common sense, intellectuality and rationality became very important. So next one is of age of enlightenment at the same time in Europe. There many revolution happened, such as the American Revolution and French Revolution, the great thoughts which were brought from the revolution, the nature was given importance. So these all things influenced the English people and their writing. So viewers, if you like my video, if you really like this video, please share it, subscribe it and like it. Thank you.